Good morning. This video is in English. This is pertaining specifically to the proposal of funds to the EU, the European Union, for the Ballet Embassy. Now, it will be 10 million euros each year, and respectively it will be for many variations of the business. Specifically, I want this 10 million on receipt to also go not only to the ballet of the opera houses persons, but to the opera itself, the opera people, and then to the musicians. So I wanted to expand, and so there are three different facets of it. But for the proposal for the ballet only, it will be the 10 million. So 10 million for the ballet, 10 million for the opera, 10 million for the musicians. Okay, from the EU each year. Now the funding specifically, we have a measly, very small amount, 5,000 each year, given to 1,000 dancers, former dancers of the opera houses. Now, when I say of the opera houses, they have to have worked in the opera houses over 2 years, or have been a guest performer as a principal dancer, soloist several times in their lifetime. So not just a hit or miss, and then and you receive. But you have to have worked in one of the state opera houses. So it has to have been a state of Germany, has to have been a state of Switzerland, has to have been a state of France, a state of anything that is supplied monetarily, where your paycheck came from the state. It's only for those particular dancers. Okay, so 1,000. 1,000 of you, there will be I'm going to call it an indigent fund, but it is a starving artist fund of 5,000 each year. Now, with these people, these 1,000, I have intentions of you having co-share habitations of 5 people or more, sharing, being able to share a normal house, a normal life, sharing one car, sharing quite a bit of your living facilities. That's how you can survive off the 5,000 each. Now, so it will support 1,000 of you that have left the theater, that are no longer the dancers of. Now, in this contingency fund, these thousands, it's no free deal. You're still going to have to supply part of something, and particularly as an artist, I prefer some of you to paint, and we can reuse your paint works. We can put them back into the theater. We can use them on the bureau, on the brochures. We can use them on the posters. We can use all of your artwork. We can resell your artwork. And the money that we use from the reselling of your artwork, we will use to repurchase houses for more dancers who are retired. So that's how it's going to be. The starving artists, and from festivals and things like this, where we sell your artwork after the dance, you will go to. That'll go to a fund that pays for additional housing for more disparate dancers in their situation. So that's 1,000 of you will receive this 5,000. Now, I have also the a need for this is out of the 10 million. Okay, so that's 1 million gone. Is that only 1 million gone? Oh my gosh, I didn't write it all down, dang it. Oh gosh, I had it in my head this morning early. Okay, we have 1 million gone that is for, I believe that's 2 million. I believe that it was 2 million already. I'm sorry. So yeah, you have the five breaks it into 20 is fed into 100,000, so you get to 200 out of, sorry, oh my gosh, I can't stop the video and pause it. I don't have that equipment. Gosh dang it. Oh, 5 million, I'm sorry. So that's 5 million. That's the initial 5 million. Okay, then 1 million of that goes to an extra amount, goes towards the health care that is not supplied. Okay, so this is going to go toward health care. And so there we have the, so you can all go to the dentist and these types of things. And you know, be treated as normal human beings. So that'll be 6 million. Okay, so now I'm looking at it, we have 4 million remaining. Now we have the offices, the head offices and the head offices are gonna be 50 people who work for the Ballet Embassy, and they will receive a payment of 20,000 a year, very small, but the 20,000 a year is enough to support 50 jobs. And so there is your 7 million. Now there is another entity, and that's going to be a fulfillment center. The fulfillment center, I only need one fulfillment center for the state opera houses. And it's going to be the sets that they don't no longer want. It's going to be the costumes they no longer want. It's going to be the pointe shoes that they no longer want. Now they are going to be recycle centers. So you have those pointe shoes on your shelf for 3 years. The dancer is not returning. You send them to our fulfillment center, and once they're in the fulfillment center, we swap them with other theaters. So if somebody needs that shoe that's a size 4C, a 4, a double XC, or whatever, with a special bridge or whatever on it, that particular emblem, we'll have it there, and we'll be able to ship it to the theater. And so it's a recycle, so it doesn't cost, there's no additional money fund out to any of the state. If anything, it's a cheaper event. It's going to be cheaper for the state. So. Yeah, because we'll be supplying their graphic arts supply for much of the theater. So where was I? I have the fulfillment center. The fulfillment center costs at 1 million euros a year. Now the next fund is going to be for 50 people that work that fulfillment center. So I'm going to be hiring 50 people for that fulfillment center itself, because we have to keep that action going all the time. And so that's another 20,000 a year each. So that's 50 people employed that way. So where was I? Had the 5,000. I have the 5,000 for the actual, sorry, the 5 million for the 5,000 for the 1,000 dancers. I have the 1 million for the, you know, what do you call it, the health. I have the I have the 1 million for the people who are actually running the Ballet Embassy itself. So that's at 7. I have 8. I have the people who are running the fulfillment center. I have 9. The fulfillment center itself, the cost of it, running it. And so we have one last million to spend. And that one last million is to spend specifically as a job placement center. A job placement center, so let's say you're a choreographer and you need a job, and over here, let's say in Munich, they need 3 choreographers in a hurry. We're going to be the job placement center in a hurry. So we cut down the costs of them seeking out that choreographer. We'll be the choreographer center. We'll be the job placement center for directors. We'll be the job placement center even for dancers that want to continue dancing. But it's only going to be for the current dancers that have contracts. It's only applying to the dancers that have ever had contracts in the theaters. It does not apply to anybody new. I am sorry, I'm not able to fulfill that. That's just way too much auditioning and all of that. If you want to go with all of this auditioning, you know, that's going to be something else. That's going to be another cost. The actual job placement center is $1 million itself, and that's the way it goes. And so that's what we're looking at as a money proposal, is 10 million euros to run the entity itself. And that will support 1,000 starving artists as well. Give another 100 jobs, careers to the dancers. Now, who else? Who am I looking at? I'm looking at, yeah. It's gonna, because we speak so many languages. We speak everything. It seems like we're gonna have to think about. Gosh dang it! I'm sorry, my shoulder. We have to think about exactly what language and where is this fulfillment center itself. I prefer the south of France. I know it seems costly, but not near Arles. I prefer that for the major center, for the embassy itself, for the 1,000 to live. I prefer that because of its drier location, because our joints are specifically, and we're going to be painting. We're going to be doing a lot of painting, and we need to keep this injection of our graphic arts skills back to the theater, and so we need a location. We need a location that is not kept in damp and mold at all. We have to keep the product of the theater alive and ready to ship back to another theater. So we're going to be move it this way. Oh gosh, I could do that. Oh my gosh, ouch. So if we're talking, it has to be a very dry zone with very little rain. So I'm looking at that region. Fréjus, Arles, as an area that is cheaper, as a cheaper area in France. I'm also looking at Béziers. We can look at the Béziers region, but I think we need to be closer to the Nice airport. We have to be close to the Nice airport, because as a placement center, we may find a lot of people need to actually visit. The choreographers themselves may want to visit and you know, give their wares or their particular CDs or whatever to us, and so we're also going to be doing other things, such as some kind of critiquing. We're going to also be in charge of quite a bit of the critiques that go on. So I expect a critique group out of you. So it's not going to be a 5,000 freebie, so don't get it off of your excitement pinnacle that you have been in a company for 3 years and now you're going to just join the 5,000 indigents. It doesn't work that way. You're going to have to realize it doesn't work that way. You're not welcome. And it's going to be people that are invited. I'm not taking criminals. I'm not accepting people that have been in prison, long endurances. No, I'm not sure what to do about you. Maybe I'll deal with you in another manner. But right now, that's not part of the 10 million. So, ouch. So here goes. So this is the basically the proposal for it, where the 10 million goes each year, and so it's basically a starving artists fund, but it's one that keeps the starving artists in continual work. With the state theaters as they are now, and also used as recycling centers for everything, you know, from the curtains to our pointe shoes. So nothing will be wasted. And Likewise, no further costs have to be endured unnecessarily. You know, if you need the Willy out, the Willy costumes, go ahead. You can have the Sylph costumes. You know, if you're never going to do them again for another 10 years, and you praise, you know, everybody on the planet for never doing it again, but you want another type of costume, you can swap them. So we'll do that type of a deal, and we'll be responsible for that. So, yeah, okay. I think that's explanatory. So that's my EU proposal for the 10 million, and I'm certain I will receive much support from everybody, from all of you directors out there across Germany, from the directors of the ballet right here in France, directors of the ballet in Austria. I expect Italy to be quite happy with it also. All of you. I mean, we're a big EU here. We have Hungary, we have Portugal, we have Spain, we have Czechoslovakia, we have all of these countries, and we have all of these dancers that we have to care for. So this is my start, is the 1,000 starving artists fund. All right, and so that's what you'll all be up to. If you make more money over you know, just the regular doings, then you're not included any longer. So it's not going to be like you can just join in, you know, get the 5,000 and yet still work as a realtor. No, it's not going to be that kind of a deal. You're either in or you're out. So you're going to be a little bit of a slave for the kingdom forever, and that's the way it goes. All right. Okay. Yeah, 10 million euros. Thank you very much, everybody who understood me. Each year, Ballet Embassy.